네, 안녕하세요. 우리가. 예, 안녕하세요. 스페큘레이티브 하드웨어에 대해서 우리가 이제 저 수업을 이제 진행을 하도록 하겠습니다. 어쨌든 이제 토마슬로 알고리즘에서 발전된 형태가 이제 스페큘레이티브 하드웨어고요. 이는 이제 토마슬로의 그런 단점. 어떤 단점이 있었죠? 브랜치 넘어서 우리가 그 인스트럭션을 out of order로 수행할 수 없다라는 그런 단점이 있었고, 그 다음에 pre-size exception을 이제 지원하지 못한다는 단점이 있었습니다. 그래서 이제 그거를 어떻게 이제 해결을 했느냐. 가장 그 특징적인 하드웨어, the representative hardware of the speculative execution is ROP죠. Reorder buffer. So this reorder buffer is the some core feature of the speculative hardware. So 그래서 그 reorder buffer가 있어서 우리가 어떤 거를 분리할 수 있다라고 했죠? Completion, instruction completion하고 instruction commit을 우리가 이제 분리를 할수 있게 되었습니다. 예, 굉장한 발전이죠. 예. 그래서 이제 그 우선은 이제 프리스 그요 브랜치는 브랜치 인스트럭션 넘어서 우리가 수행할 수 있다라는 거, 그 플러스 프리사이즈 엑셉션을 지원할 수 있다라는 거, 그것이 이제 굉장한 그런 발전이라고 이제 보면 되겠습니다. 그래서 이제 우리가 다시 브랜치라는 것이 계속 말을 하지만은 그 인스트럭션 뭐 4.5개 그 평균적으로 그 4개에서 5개 인스트럭션 있으면 브랜치는 거의 이제 on average 등장을 해요. 그렇기 때문에 브랜치를 넘어서 이제 execution이 불가능하다고 하면은 굉장한 performance override가 발생하는 거죠. performance degradation. 그러니까 이제 브랜치 넘어서 우리가 수행할 수 있다는 거. 그 다음에 브랜치라는 것이 다행히도 우리가 많이 쓰는 iterative loop 같은 경우에는 굉장히 high probability로 prediction이 가능하다. 그건 다행이죠. fortunately. 물론 if나 뭐 이런 스테이트먼트는 좀 다른 이야기지만 최소한 iterative loop 같은 경우에는 우리가 굉장히 높은 퍼센티지로 프레딕션이 가능하다는 거죠. 그래서 이런 여러 가지 이제 테크닉들과 그다음에 observation들을 합쳐서 이제 고안이 된 것이 speculative hardware, speculative execution입니다. 굉장히 이제 중요한 그런 하드웨어적인 아키텍처적인 이제 진보가 되겠고요. 그래서 이제 퍼포먼스는 굉장히 그 컴퓨터의 그 퍼포먼스가 굉장히 이제 좋아지는 그런 발전이 되겠습니다. 그래서 이제 so we are learning about the speculative hardware. So as I explained, the core feature of the speculative hardware is to separate the instruction completion and instruction commit. So this separation depends on the reorder buffer. So the reorder buffer is the core hardware of the speculative Thomas' law. And then in this slide, I will explain how to handles the branch misprediction event and exception in the Thomas' law, speculative Thomas' law. So the behavior of the branch is predicted by the dynamic branch predictor called the BPB. So when I explain about the architecture of the speculative Thomas' law, so in the instruction fetch, there is branch prediction buffer and the branch target buffer. So based on these hardware branch predictors, we can predict the next program counter beyond the branch instruction. So, where's this? What happened? Okay. So we can accelerate. So we can increase the performance of the out of order processor based on this branch prediction and speculative hardware. But note that this is just the prediction. So that means that the predicted result can be incorrect, even though the prediction hit ratio is can be very high, but we can expect that some prediction result can be incorrect. So how can we handle the, this mispredicted branch event? So the major change of the speculative Thomas law is the ROB. So let's talk about the ROB in the event of the branch misprediction. So I already told that ROB is the just the FIFO. It's a first in, first out buffer, and then there are two pointers to for the of the this ROB Lyoto buffer. So the first pointer is the dispatch pointer. What happened? And then the second pointer is commit or retire pointer. So the instructions, some executed instructions are stored between this dispatch pointer and commit pointer. So instructions are registered to the ROB when the instructions on instruction is dispatched. So when the instruction is dispatched, the ROB entry is occupied by the a certain instruction. And then what is the commit pointer? So instruction is, so between the dispatch pointer and the commit pointer, there are some various kinds of instructions. Some instructions are stored in the issue queues, or some instructions are the instructions are already completed. So some different state of the instruction is different status of instruction exist in the Lyoto buffer between dispatch pointer and commit pointer. And then once the instruction is committed, then we don't need to care about the committed instruction. So this is the invalidated entries in ROB. So these entries are invalidated. So this is some available entries for the dispatch. So that means that in the ROB buffer, so this is the commit pointer, and then this is the dispatch pointer. So let us assume that branch instruction is here, and then in the speculative hardware, the out of order completion is possible. So that means that the result of the branch instruction can be already completed even though this branch is not committed. So that can be completed earlier, but until this branch is committed, the branch remains silent. So branch remains silent until the top of the ROB. So top of the ROB means is the entries pointed by commit pointer. So branch remains silent until the top of the ROB, and then if the branch is located on the top of the ROB, that means that these instructions are committed, and then the commit pointer is located at the entry which contains the branch instruction. Then the branch instructions can be committed. So that means that the result of the branch instruction, like a taken or not taken, is decided when the branch is committed. So the computer processor knows, actually computer processor can know the result of the branch instruction when the branch instruction is completed, but the operation by the taken or not taken is committed when the branch is committed. So So this prediction can be detected when the branch is committed. So in this case, we need to invalidate the dispatched instructions. So there may be several instructions between commit point and dispatch point, dispatch pointer. And then here is the some instruction that is pending or is being executed by the functional unit. So these instructions should be cancelled. That means that these instructions should be flushed from the ROV. So actually the operation is simple with this speculative Thomas law for the event of branch misprediction. Also, all executing instructions in the backend of the out-of-order processor also should be flushed. So basically, if the branch is mispredicted, the all instructions after the branch instruction, so following the branch instructions, should be flushed in the hardware of the computer processor. And then after the instructions are flushed, then the commit pointer and dispatch pointer is pointing the same entry of the read buffer. Okay, and then with the corrected target address of the branch instruction, the instruction fetch unit fetch the correct instructions with the correct target. So this is the operation of the speculative hardware for the event of branch misprediction. And then let's talk about the exception. So actually the exception is the kind of branch instruction. That's why it's right. So when exception happens, when the exception is committed in the processor, then the processor flushes the following instructions and the flushes the following instruction when the exception happens, and then the computer, actually the operating system calls the exception handler. So exception handler is the kind of program code that handles the exception event. So it's very similar to the some procedure call. So it's the kind of a branch instruction. So actually the precise exception can be supported by the speculative Thomas law because the commit is in order commit. So it's a very good advantage of, this is the advantage of speculative Thomas law. So it's in when the exception happens, when the exception is detected in the functional unit or some other hardware unit of the processor, then exceptions are flagged in the ROV. But this flag just mark that the exceptions happens. And then this exception is not handled until this instruction is committed. So exceptions are flagged, that means the exceptions are marked in the ROV, and then but remain silent. So when this instruction is committed, the exception, the processor checks the exception flags stored in the ROV, and then if the exception is detected, that means that the exception is marked in the ROV, then processor calls the exception handler, and so handles the exception. So it's the same to the branch misprediction. So exception is detected by in the ROV, the following instruction. So there may be some several instructions between commit pointer and dispatch pointer on the ROV. So the entire instructions between this commit and dispatch pointer should be flushed. And then the operating system calls the so exception handler. So and then the this address of the exception handler is defined by the operating system, and so handler instruction must be fetched by the processor. So the operation of a mispredicted branch instruction and then operation of the exception is very similar. So we can share the good thing is that we can share the hardware, same hardware for the mispredicted branch recovery. So because the operation is the same, okay? So it's a very good thing of the speculative hardware, I repeat. And then how about the handling the memory instructions? So actually with the out of the processor, we handle the hazard of the data hazard, like a wow hazard and then war hazard. So and then I repeat that I already explained that low hazard is the true hazard. So actually hardware cannot solve this low hazard because the low hazard is defined by the programs. So hardware cannot solve this low hazard without the value prediction, but this wow and war hazard is automatically solved by the out of the processor or speculative Thomas law with the register renaming. So actually the behavior of load, execution of the load and store instruction is same to the Thomas law. So this is the summarized operation of the memory operation in the speculative hardware. So first, the load store instruction issued to the LSQ, load store queue, through the address generation unit. So in order to execute the load store instruction, we first need to know the target address of the load store instruction. So AGU, address generation unit, also exists in the speculative hardware, speculative Thomas law. And then it's the same. Stores are split into two sub-instructions. The one instruction calculates the target address, and then the second instruction just performs the store instruction. So storing data to the data memory, the main memory. And then, so address generation unit and the store instruction. So it is because the store instruction is very important. So the store instruction changes the data of the computer system. So that means that store instruction can change the status of the computer system. So store instruction is very important. Then for the load, actually the load instruction is also important for the performance of the computer system, but load instruction does not change the status of the data. Right, okay. So store instruction is very important for the performance, and then some other issues in the multi-core, and some is this out of the core processor. So this store instruction, actually the load instruction, there is no data change with this load instruction. Actually the register can be changed, but no data change in the memory by the load instruction, but store instruction is different. So store instruction, instruction, because the stores are split into two sub instruction, store A, store D. The store D instructions is committed. So that means that store instruction is performed when the store D instruction is committed. So this is the operation, some different operation of the store instruction with the speculative hardware. So store is only performed when the store D instruction is committed. So with this change the operation, the good thing is that wow and war hazard are automatically solved with the speculative hardware. So When the wow hazard and war hazard happens. If the order of the store instruction is changed, so if the order of the store instruction is out of order, then we need the wow hazard and the war hazard can happen. But when the store instruction is committed in order, then the order of the write operation for the data memory, write to data mem, is also ordered. So that's the good thing is that wow hazard, war hazard are automatically solved. So we don't need to care about take. We don't need to care about this wow hazard and war hazard in the for the memory instructions. So and how about the low hazard? This low hazard, we cannot solve this low hazard because the read operation, by the load instruction, what happened? Okay, can be performed after the store instruction is update the data in the memory. So if the address is the same, store A and store B, then this load instruction cannot be executed. So data should be updated in the memory. So actually, if the address is different, so and then the this target address already have the updated value, then load can issue to the cache as soon as it reaches the LSQ. The load instruction can be executed. But if the address is the same, then because of the array low hazard of the memory, then this load instruction can be executed. So load instruction should remain in the load store queue until the store instruction is committed. It's committed. So I already explained that the store instruction is executed when the store instruction is committed in ROB. So that means that before this store instruction is committed, the load instruction cannot be executed. So it's the big problem. If the if the store instruction is not, so the this low hazard to the memory is the big problem, also the some critical performance hurdle in the processor. So how can we solve this instruction? The first thing is that if we know the address of the store instruction as soon as possible, so quickly, so then we can solve this operation, this low hazard problem. That's why the store instruction is split into two sub instructions, address generation and data transfer. But the problem is caused by unknown address of the store instruction. So problem is that if the address of the store instruction is unknown, then we don't know the target address of the store instruction. Then we need to decide if the load instruction can be executed or not. So there may be possible that this following load, the address of the this following load instruction can be same to the unknown address of the store instruction. So that's the problem. So this issue is called the memory disambiguation. So how can you solve this memory disambiguation? So actually I believe I already explained in the Thomas Lowe algorithm, so there can be the conservative approach. This is the safe approach, and then the conservative. So that means that the performance can be low. So it's a conservative approach. We assume that if the address of the store instruction is unknown, then this unknown address is matched to the following load instructions. Address of the following load instruction. So this is a store instruction A and then load A, load B, load C. So actually we know that if we know the all addresses of these memory of instructions, and then we know that only these two memory instructions, store and load, has the same addresses, but these two load instructions has the different target address. So if we already know the address of the store instruction, then this load and B, load B and load C can be executed in the hardware. But if this address is unknown, how can we handle these three load instructions? The conservative approach means that the computer processor assumes that this address of the store instruction is same to the A, B, C. So the following load instruction cannot be executed, or following instruction. So problem is that, so this is the very safe approach. So this approach is called the conservative approach. So the problem is that, as shown in this example, if the address of the store instruction can be same to the only one load instruction, and then for this load instruction, actually the addresses are not matched with the address of the store instruction, but this load instruction cannot be executed. Also, this case, so in the program, let us assume that if we perform this store A and then load A, so this case is very rare in the real application. As you can see, the low hazard, read and write dependence between the register file can be observed frequently in the program because this is the register file. But this case, the low hazard, the read and just to store the data to the memory and then load the value from the memory just after the store instruction. This is some dumb operation, right? So we can use the register file for this case, but this is very rare in the real application. But this conservative approach just in order to handle these rare cases, conservative approach assume that the address of the store instruction is the same to the following load instruction, so performance is degraded very much. But this problem is that this case is rare. So what is the optimistic approach? So this is the speculative, also speculative disambiguation. So actually it is not easy to predict the address of the load instruction because the address is calculated dynamically in the program, in the code. But we know it's just some probability issue, but we know that this case, store A and just after store and then load A, this case is very rare in the real program. So speculative disambiguation means that we assume that even though the address of the store instruction is unknown, then we assume that this address is not equal to the address of the following load instructions. And then performs the load instruction. So the good thing is that load instruction does not change the content of the memory. The load instruction just transfer the data in the memory to the register file. Also, in the speculative hardware, before this load instruction is committed, okay, before this load instruction is committed, this fetched data is not updated to the register file. That is a good thing. The fetched data is only stored in the ROB entry. So this is the this can be the speculative load. So in the ROB, this is the store instruction, but the address of the store instruction is unknown currently, and this is a load instruction. This load instruction is performed with its own address, even though the processor does not know the address of the load store instruction. And then the follow instruction is also executed. Follow instruction is executed. So executed speculatively. What happened? What happened? Okay. And then, so this is the speculative load instruction. This speculative disambiguation. So, and then that means that this speculative operation can be incorrect. So even though the probability is very low, this prediction can be incorrect. That can be possible. So what should we do for this incorrect prediction? Incorrect some optimistic approach of the load instruction. So like the mispredicted mispredicted branch instruction, we can mark the speculative load in the ROB, and then if the speculation is wrong, so that means incorrect, then just roll back the these instruction by the load instruction. So the load instruction works as the mispredicted so incorrect load instruction can work as the mispredicted branch instruction. So and then it is a rollback from the reload buffer. So speculative assume that the address are different from the load address. And then so load instruction is performed. That means that load instruction fetch the data from the memory. So it should load the cache. So cache is accessed by the load instruction. And then the fetch data is stored in the ROB entry. So when the store address has been computed, is completed. So store instruction is split into two sub instruction, STA, and then STB, and then the D. So if the address is calculated, then we can check that this address is the same to the load instruction or not. So check this equality of the address between store instruction and load instruction. Then already completed, then the load and the all follow instruction must be replayed. So it's flushed from the reload buffer. So in order to support this operation, we may check some completed mark in the load instruction, and then if this load instruction is completed, the follow instruction like this stored in the ROE buffer should be flushed. So it works as the incorrect load was the mispredicted branch. Okay, this is the some optimistic approach, and then also you can find the some issue in the in the this optimistic approach. What's that issue? So actually, the register file RF is not updated, but which component is updated? Cache can be updated. So actually the cache is the temporary memory. So actually for the performance issue and some the execution of the program, even though the cache is incorrectly updated, but that's not important in the correction of correct execution of the program. But recently we need to consider the some security issue of the computer processor, and then this side channel attack can be performed for the some cache memory, so it's possible. Then we also we can check that this some on what's that. So we need to we may is in order to defend we not the what's that. So in order to detect no. in order to secure the operation the data of in the processors, so we may check the some suspicious load instruction for the cache memory. So 그래서 이제 좀 정리를 하자면은 사실 optimistic approach는 뭐 그렇게 뭐 퍼포먼스를 생각을 하면은 예 굉장히 뭐 별 문제가 없는 그런 어프로치라고 이제 볼 수가 있겠죠. 왜냐면은 우리는 그 even though the load instruction의 그 address가 뭐 어차피 뭐 똑같다고 하더라도 뭐만 업데이트가 돼요? 캐시만 업데이트가 돼요. 레지스터 파일은 업데이트가 안 돼요. with the speculative hardware. 그러니까는 사실 뭐 캐시가 잘못 업데이트 된다거나 하는 거는 그냥 뭐 이거는 그 퍼포먼스 이슈지 뭐 프로그램이 이제 잘못 수행된다거나 이런 이슈는 아니라는 걸 알 수가 있죠. 뭐 그냥 전통적으로 캐시 같은 경우에는 진짜 그냥 어차피 이제 얘가 캐시가 뭐 잘못 업데이트 돼도 우리는 그 메인 메모리만 신경 쓰면 되니까는 뭐 이렇게 뭐 별로 이슈가 되는 부분 아니야. 그러니까 퍼포먼스 이슈가 될 수 있지만 퍼포먼스를 빼고는 전혀 이슈가 되지 않는 그런 문제였습니다. 근데 이제 요새는 뭐 사이드 채널 어택이라고 해가지고 캐시의 그 타이밍 디퍼런스를 가지고서 이제 뭐 데이터를 뭐 캐치를 한다든지 이렇게 스파이웨어가 그 시큐리티 어택커가 이제 캐치를 한다든지 뭐 이런 것들이 이제 또 발생을 하기 때문에 그러니까 전통적으로는 이제 문제가 없었던 그런 그 프로세서 이슈들이 뭐 이런 캐시 업데이트마저도 뭔가 이제 문제가 되는 그런 뭐 시대가 되었다라고 해야 되나요? 예, 그거를 좀 얘기를 한 겁니다. 그러니까 사실 optimistic approach는 굉장히 이제 뭐 별 문제가 되지 않는 approach예요. 왜냐면은 우선 이런 케이스 스토어랑 로드 인스트럭션이랑 완전히 매치가 되는 케이스는 굉장히 rare하고요. 그렇기 때문에 우리가 이제 speculatively 로드 인스트럭션을 수행하더라도 이렇게 롤백을 할 그런 케이스는 뭐 그렇게 발생하지 않을 수가 있어요. 그러니까 퍼포먼스 상으로는 그냥 로드 인스트럭션 바로 수행을 해버리는 것이 퍼포먼스 상에는 이득이고 그 다음에 뭐 별 단점은 거의 없고 뭐 그런 방법인데 이제 우리가 이제 시큐리티까지 이제 고려를 해야 되는 상황이 왔기 때문에 예, 좀 문제가 될 수도 있다라는 거를 뭐 좀 말을 해주는 겁니다. So this is the some optimistic approach, and then also we can select, we can choose the some intermediate approach. So what does that mean? Sometimes dumb programmers. can assign the store instruction, so store instruction access the same address, and then the load instruction just step to the store instruction. So if that case happens for the some specific load instruction, then we can mark that this optimistic approach does not work for the a certain load instruction. So just to track the load PC, and then if the this optimistic approach does not work for the for a certain load instruction, then based on this some marked PC, then we can apply the some this memory disambiguation ish conservatively. So this approach is very similar to the branch predictor, but that means that in order to apply that this approach, intermediate approach, then we need some similar hardware, the hardware component that is similar to the branch predictor. So 코스트가 들어간다는 거죠. 네. So this is this table shows the some clock timing, clock cycle, and the some execution of the instruction in the speculative hardware. So I recommend you to compare this table with the table of Thomas' algorithm, original Thomas' algorithm. So with the speculative Thomas' law, this column is included. It's a retire or commit. So this retire is frequently called the commit or graduation. 졸업. So this stage is included based on the Thomas' law algorithm. Let's see the some operation of the instruction. So that's dispatch. So the instructions is dispatched in order. So if there are some available entries in the ROB or SQs and then load store queues, then instruction can be dispatched at every cycle. 당연하죠. 라는 우리가 이제 structure hazard issue만 없다고 하면은 instruction은 in order로 every cycle에 dispatch가 될수 있겠죠. So as cycle 1, the load instruction is dispatched, and then let us assume that the hardware is also available. So load instruction can be issued right after the right after dispatch, and then the execution can be started and completed, and then this is load instruction is the memory instruction, so that means that the cache memory should be accessed by this load instruction. So cache is here, cache should be accessed, and then we assume that the cache hit if this data is exists in the cache memory, that means its event is cache hit, always cache hit here. It's not always cache hit, but in this example, we assume that the data is hit in the cache. So the fetch data is sent to the CDB common data bus, and then after 1 clock, the data can be retired from the ROB. So when the instruction is dispatched, the instruction is registered in the ROB and then retired. The instruction is graduated from the ROB at clock cycle 6. Then it's the same, there is no data dependence between I1 and I2. And then for this add instruction, is the floating point add instruction. So there is data dependence in the F1, also F0. But we need to wait for F1, the processor need to wait for F1. So when the load instruction is completed, this load instruction is completed at clock cycle 6, and then so the data can be delivered to the this add instruction after 1 clock. So add instruction is fetched at cycle 7, and then the one clock is executed, and then let us assume that it's a floating point operation, so it takes 5 clocks. So some assumption completed at 13. How about the store instruction? Store instruction is split into two instructions here, and then each instruction is dispatched at every cycle at 4 and 5. So this the address generation can be easily executed, issued to the address generation unit at 5 because the R1 is already ready in the register file, and then it's completed. So this is some virtual instruction. It's not real instruction. So it's just executed and completed here. So no need to be stored, sent to the CDB, common data bus. And how about this store instruction? So store instruction should be wait for F2. So when the F2 is available after clock cycle 13. So this store instruction can be issued at 14, executed, and then access the cache. And then after this store instruction is executed, this store instruction is committed. Retired from the ROB, so it's for F2. So actually, in the previous slide, I explained that the store instruction is performed at when the committed, so this order is just before the this retirement. So this the store instruction should be committed in the order of the ROB. So and then so it's just the 1 clock before the commit of the store instruction. And then let's see the add instruction. This add instruction is an integer instruction. Then you can see the some following the completion and then at cycle 8, 9. But the speculative hardware is the in order commit. So in the at the cycle 18, the add instruction is committed. That means that the register file R1 is updated at clock cycle 18. So we need to wait until the this store instruction is committed, the add instruction. How about the branch instruction? So for the branch instruction, the R3 should be completed. Completed, R3 should be calculated. So, also the branch instruction need to wait the R3, but so we know that the R3 is completed at clock cycle 12, but there is the CDB conflict, the common data bus conflict. So because of the in I10, where is the I10? Oh, I10 is here. So CDB is occupied by the this. What's this? So I the load story load this load instruction like a. This instruction and this instruction. So that means the is a 13, 14. So what's this? Let's see the some structure of the branch instruction here. So the CDB. So CDB can be accessed by the floating point and then So actually, we need to consider the some com so structural hazard of the CDB common data bus. But so actually, this table shows that the branch instruction is conflict is because of the CDB conflict, even though the R3 is complete. So R3, we know that R3 is completed at the clock 12, but because of the CDB conflict, then this branch instruction cannot be issued. But I need to check the this CDB conflict here, because CDB is conflicted with the load instruction is here. And then so I will check the this slide again after this lecture, and then I will let you know in the later. So branch instruction is issued at 14 and 15, executed at clock cycle 15, and then retired at 21. And then this is the feature of the speculative hardware. So for the load instruction can be issued. So for the Thomas Lowe algorithm, this load instruction cannot be issued before the branch instruction I9 is completed. But this load instruction can be issued regardless of the result of the branch instruction, and then it's completed at 14 and 15. But it's committed at 12, 22, and 23. And this add instruction with for F1 again. So so this is the feature of the speculative hardware. So a new column is included, and then load can be dispatched right after the branch, this load instruction. So this is the dispatched branch instruction, and then store can to cache must be wait until it reached the top of the ROB. So store is committed at 8:17, and then access the cache just one clock before the commit of the store instruction. So 16. So this is the feature of the speculative hardware. So let's compare with the Thomas Lowe algorithm. So for the Thomas Lowe algorithm, this load instruction cannot be dispatched after the branch instruction, I9 for in dispatch. So here and here, that's the some. Also, store instruction is access the cache regardless of the commit order of the instruction. So this is some major difference of the speculative hardware. Then we check the some this issue here. Okay, what's this? Okay. So let me check the time. Okay. Ah, 네. 잠시 그 제가 이제 요 어쨌든 이게 녹화 수업이니까 장점을 잘 살려서 이게 왜 그 지금 저 브랜치 인스트럭션이 여기 수행이 되는데 왜 이제 conflict with I10 and I11인지 좀 생각을 해봤습니다. 아, so 그래서 그 문제가 뭐냐면은 자, 저 for this branch instruction can be issued because at clock 12, 그 맞죠? It's because the result of this sub I instruction is sent to the CDB at clock 11, 그렇죠? So this data is read, can be ready for issued at clock 12 for the, this branch instruction. So 근데 그러니까는 이제 저 여기서 이제 CDB에 이제 데이터가 실리면은 그 다음 클락에 뭐 이슈가 가능합니다. 그렇게 이제 우리가 했는데, 자, so problem is that If the branch instruction is issued at 12, then it should be 13, and then 13. And the memory is not accessed for the integer instruction, then the CDB should be the occupied by the branch instruction at 14. 여기에 뭐랑 겹쳐요? 요 load instruction이랑 겹쳐요. So for this load instruction, the also need to access the CDB at 14. So this instruction load, this branch instruction cannot be executed because of the this CDB conflict, and then also this load instruction. If 1 clock is delayed for the branch instruction, it's a 13, then it should be 14. So this CDB is also conflict with the this load instruction. So that's why in this comment column, the CDB is a conflict with I10 and I11. So the branch instruction should be issued at 14 in order to avoid the CDB conflict. 네. So 이렇게 되는데, 실제로 이제 하드웨어가 이렇게 진짜 동작을 하는지는 좀 까봐야 되겠는데요. 왜냐면은 이 어쨌든 이제 그 교과서에는 그 텍스트북에서는 그 항상 우리는 데이터 미스는 없다. The data is always hit in the data cache라고 가정을 하기 때문에 여기가 이제 한 클락 걸리는데, 사실은 이게 추론은 아니죠. 그래서 이제 요거를 고려를 해서 이게 계속 밀린다는 좀 이상하긴 한데, 뭐 밀리더라도 그 실제적으로는 그 펑셔널 유닛에서 리플레이를 큐를 뭐 집어넣는다든지 해가지고 그냥 뭐 이슈를 빨리 해놓고 그렇게 할 수 있을 것 같은데 좀 이제 복잡하게 돼 있는 것 같습니다. Anyway, 여기서 이제 컨플릭트 때문에 할 수 없다라는 거는 요것 때문에. 예. 라고 이제 여러분들이 이제 이해를 하시면 되겠습니다. 그래서 실제적으로는 근데 역시나 이제 그 우리가 execution time of the load instruction은 뭐 잘 정확하게 알 수가 없기 때문에 그냥 하고 이슈를 시키고 그냥 기다릴 것 같은데 뭐 이렇게 되네요. So anyway, 어쨌든 그 이게 common data bus이기 때문에 이게 모든 인스트럭션이 다 액세스를 할 수는 없어요. 그러니까는 뭐 이런 것들 이제 다 고려를 해줘야 되겠고요. 예, 그런 부분들을 뭐 생각을 해서 이렇게 된다고 보시면 되겠습니다. 예, 제 욕심 같아서는 빨리 레지스터 리네이밍까지 이제 가고 싶은데, 네, 레지스터 리네이밍도 또 역시나 또 중요한 이슈고, 좀 더 이제 그 여기 다이나믹 그 아웃 오브 오더 프로세스를 좀 더 이제 확실하게 이제 다루기 위해서 레지스터 리네이밍과 이런 부분들은 좀 나중에 다음 시간에 다루도록 하겠습니다. 예, 사실 그 세이브를 해놓고 어쨌든 이제 그 이 아웃 오브 오더 프로세스는 좀 중요한 이슈이기 때문에 제가 이제 조금 좀 자세하게 뭐 복습도 하면서 리뷰도 하면서 이제 좀 하고 있는데요. 뭐 어쨌든 여러분들의 이제 좀 그 지금 이제 제가 이제 온라인 수업을 이제 진행을 하고 있고, 그렇지만 이제 향후 스케줄을 봐가지고 좀 내용을 좀 수정할 필요도 있을 것 같다라는 생각이 듭니다. 뭐 실제적으로는 뭐 캐시까지 이제 다 다룰까 했었는데, 캐시는 어차피 이제 undergraduate computer architecture 코스에서 뭐 다 다루는 내용이 좀 중복이 되기 때문에 이렇게 컴퓨터 프로세서 코어 부분을 좀 자세하게 다루고, 그 다음에 그 컴퓨터 아키텍처 시뮬레이터 쓰는 법, 이런 부분과 이슈들에 대해서 좀 더 설명을 하고, 캐시랑 뭐 메모리 시스템은 뭐 다음 학기라든지 아니면 다른 학기에 이제 설명한다든지 그런 식으로 이제 진행을 아니면은 아주 빠르게 설명하고 넘어간다든지 이렇게 할까 좀뭐 생각 중입니다. 그래서 저 지금 스페큘레이티브 아키텍처 이 부분 스페큘레이티브 토마슬로 부분은 이걸로 이제 마치고요. 다음 시간에는 이제 레지스터 리네이밍하고 그다음에 스페큘레이티브 익스큐션에 대해서 이제 좀 하도록 하겠습니다. 예, 수고 많으셨고요. 특히 이 아웃오브 워드 프로세서 부분이 이제 중요한 부분이기 때문에 여러분들도 이제 잘 이제 공부를 하시고 그러면 좋을 것 같습니다. 네, 감사합니다. 수고 많았습니다.